Hi, everybody. This is Brian from the broadcast team here at Family Talk, part of Dr. James Dobson's Family Institute. We're here today with Dr. Robert Jeffress, pastor from First Baptist Dallas. Robert, welcome to Family Talk.
It's good to be back again.
Your new book, Choosing the Extraordinary Life, God's Seven Secrets for Success and Significance. Tell us about what you were here to talk to Dr. Dobson about.
Well, you know, a lot of Christians go through life without any sense of purpose. They're like that Chicago sewer worker who, when asked why he did what he did, he said, well, let me see. I dig the ditch to earn the money, to buy the bread, to get the strength to dig the ditch. And you know, that's how a lot of Christians are living their lives. They get up, they go to work, come home, eat dinner, watch a little television, go to bed, and start it all over again. I think God has more in mind for us than that. This book is designed to help people be lifted up out of the mundane rut of everyday life and experience the life God prepared for us. And I actually used the life of Elijah as a background for this study. The seven secrets for success and significance came from the life of Elijah. You know, the Bible says he was an ordinary person, no spiritual super saint, an ordinary person whom God used in an extraordinary way in his culture. And I think God wants to do the same for us. So if you're looking for a life that is marked by passion, power, and purpose, I think you'll find that in Choosing the Extraordinary Life.
Final question. We are running up to the midterm elections. What can you tell Christians who are out there, maybe sitting on the fence, thinking, what does it matter? Sort of like Elijah, this is just my lot in life.
You know, Elijah, who had an extraordinary life, didn't feel like his mission was only to talk to God's own people, the faithful Israelites. He was willing to talk to lukewarm Israelites. He was willing to talk to King Ahab, the evil king of Israel. And without stuttering or stammering, he said, thus saith the Lord. And you know, as Christians, we pray, thy kingdom come, Lord, thy will be done on earth as it's being done in heaven. And when we pray for the will of God to be done on earth, that's not just for the future, it's right now. And I know here at the Dobson Institute, you don't believe it's God's will for 1.4 million babies to be murdered in the womb every year through abortion. It's not God's will for immorality to be running like an open sewer throughout our country. It's not God's will for Ten Commandment displays and crosses to be torn down from war memorials or from the name of Jesus to be prohibited for use in the public square. That's got to change. God is not just sovereign over the church, he's sovereign over all creation. And one way we make a difference is by the leaders we put into office. You know, in Elijah's day, you didn't get to vote for the king. Ahab was imposed on the people, and he set the course of the nation. But today, God gives us the privilege and responsibility of choosing our leaders. We determine the spiritual and moral direction of our country by the people we elect for office. And so when we go to vote, we're saying, I want the country to go this way, or I want it to go that way. Every Christian has a God-given responsibility to use that God-given privilege of voting.
Well, thank you for all of your time and all of your words of advice and encouragement. We love having you here in Colorado Springs. We love seeing you everywhere on TV, on radio, on our radio program. And we look forward to the next time we're together.
Thank you for having me.